Hello and welcome everyone to another NASCAR Racing 2003 live stream. How are you doing today? Thank you very much for joining. Please hit the like button. Subscribe to me on YouTube if you haven't already. Follow me on Twitch. Check out my Facebook page. Thank you so much for all the support. That being said, let's jump into today's video. As you can read by the title, I'm going to be attempting to recreate Cale Yarborough's 1983 Daytona qualifying flip. And for those of you that haven't seen that wreck, I am going to show you right now. Thank you to NASCAR All Out for this video clip. Go check out his channel, her channel, whoever he or she may be. So coming out of turn four, he gets loose, hits the banking, and goes over.
Gusting to 40 miles an hour.
As you will see
in turn three.
In turns three and four, yeah.
Big trouble.
Yarborough, this one's going to be tricky to be able to get airborne in the banking of the turn and flip upside down. It's going to be tricky, but I will try it. Oh yeah, by the way, thanks for watching my most recent reenactment, the Randy LaJoy 1984 Gatorade Twin 125 flip. A few people were having trouble getting the video to load. I was as well, but it eventually worked. I think it's just taken a bit to process with certain devices, but it did eventually work for me on both my computer and my laptop. Just took a bit, I think. Maybe try like in a few hours, or maybe just try checking out the video tomorrow. I think it might still just be processing. Joel Chicken Wang Productions, how are you guys doing? Alright, so I'm going to be using the Aero 88 Cup 88 mod that has the cup physics, because that goes a lot faster, and I'm going to be need to go as fast as possible for this wreck to try to get airborne and upside down in the banking of turn 4. So here we got Cale Yarborough's number 28, 1983, Hardee's Chevrolet. And we're going to be using the same version as Daytona as the last two reenactments, because that's a good 70s, 80s Daytona to use, the Grand National 70. And, oh, actually, we don't need to do a race. We need to do a testing session since he was qualifying. Let's jump in. 21 viewers already, damn. That is the most I've ever had for a Twitch, I believe. Cool. Thank you guys for joining. I'm still in the same exact transmission setup as I was for the video yesterday, where I have the direction pad instead of the paddle shifters that I'm using to shift right now, so I can directly shift down to either reverse or first gear, whichever might work better. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get as airborne as I need to in the corner. Let's try it right here. Yep, as I figured, he was just going to slide and not get airborne. That's a good noise. Sorry, just making sure the chat isn't frozen. There we go. Oh. Let's try again on the next lap. We'll try first. I tried reverse that time. Oops. I totally accidentally hit the wrong button. Meant to hit fourth, but I hit first. I think the 21 viewers was a small glitch. So now it's down to 9. I think that might... Because, yeah, I don't think it would have been that high that early on. Alright. Alright, speaking of Twitch viewers, I need to do something real quick. I'm going to promote this stream on my latest YouTube video. Let's see if it's working yet. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. Sorry guys, this will take 30 seconds and then I'll be back to crashing. Go to this, hopefully it's loading. Oh! Alright, so it is working for me again. So it just takes a bit. And... alright, here's what we do. Sorry guys, 30 more seconds. I'm getting pretty quick at doing this. Live on Twitch. Now, and then colon. My gamer ID or my Twitch link. Paste. Alright, cool. Alright, that's taken care of. Thanks for being patient with me, guys. Back to crashing. Trying to get Cale upside down and turn forward. No, don't end the session. Did I switch back to the game screen? Alright, good. I'm always paranoid I'm stuck in window mode, or I'm have the stream in window mode, and it should be in the game application mode. Window. I don't know if I use the proper words for that at all. For those of you that know OBS, probably have an idea of what I'm talking about. Let's try shifting into one. Right here. Oh, nope. I'll try reverse next time. Is my engine gone from that? Yep, that blew my engine. This one, yeah, if anyone has any suggestions for this, I was gonna have trouble with this one. If I need to change the wind to a certain direction, how does the wind blow into the car to get the car upside down? I have no idea. If I need to turn the wind way up. I'm gonna try reverse this time. Well, that wasn't how he... that wasn't the blowover flip he had, but he still flipped. Yeah, he didn't blow over. That was more of a weight shift, but... that was almost like Andy Farr's Daytona qualifying flip in 94. Kind of. It's basically exactly what that was like. Yeah, if I ever need to do Andy Farr's qualifying flip, that's a decent start right there. But except, I've tried to look for that car in the past, but I couldn't find it. Yeah, it seems, knock on wood, it seems to be working. The stream itself seems to be fine so far, so if you guys have any issues, just try refreshing. Alright, I'll try that again. Maybe I'll try another lap just to see if I can... I don't know if I'm going to go too much faster than 220 or 230. Since I need to change some settings in the track. But yeah, I'll try another lap to try to gain more speed. Shoot. I accidentally hit first again when I meant to hit fourth. And that blew my engine. So might as well restart. Damn it, why did I not save that? Or Cale flipped in case I need a thumbnail if I don't get a closer one. There we go. Fourth and first are right next to each other on the direction pad. Directional pad. try another lap to get warmed up. And try to get up to a faster speed. Though I don't think I'm going to go much faster than this. Doesn't look like I can get much faster than this. 223, 224, the top speed. Oops. Lost some momentum right there. Maybe I need to adjust the gear ratio of the car. I don't know. Alright, so I'm going to try reverse again, because that seemed to do the most last time. Still nothing. Still nothing. Still nada. It's not even getting just the slightest bit airborne going down to that banking. Not the slightest. I have an idea. Alright, so we're gonna exit out of the game quickly. Gonna go into the track folder. Here we are in the Papyrus Season Tracks, Daytona GN70. Ah. That'll help. Let's try to turn the temperature even lower. Try like -160. That might be a little excessive. Track wind speed. Let's do 40. Lots of wind might mean more prone to airborne crashes. I have no idea if that'll work. I'm just trying an experiment. Load this back up. And boom. Now, for those of you that don't know, turning the track temperature down a lot like that usually helps getting the cars have be faster and just have more acceleration in general. And then it seems to help the cars get airborne easier, at least in my experience. No, not single race, testing session. There we go. Alright, so let's see if turning the restrictor plates to 5 did anything. Seem to be going faster. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Look at that. 230. 240. Yes, I know this is way faster than he was going in real life, but I need to be going this fast. This is what's gonna happen. Oh. Oh. Nope. Alright, I might need to turn the grip up just a little bit to compensate for the heightened speed and lowered track temperature. Alright, I'm gonna exit out again real quickly. I'm not even gonna switch the game or the window over. Turning asphalt grip from 1.65 to 1.85, turning concrete grip from 1.7 to 1.9. Just turned each one up 0.2. Alright, loading the game back up. Sorry, I know it's just a black screen with some chat and my ugly face for you guys. Game will be back in a second. 3, 2, 1. There we go. Unfreeze the comments. Alright, load the... No, not the single race for the third time. Knock it off, Cody. Excuse me. Oops. Alright, we had some drop frame issues, but they're over. That'll happen every now and then on Twitch. But if you watch it on YouTube, it's uninterrupted. I apologize in advance for any dropped frames in the future. It might seem like it's cutting out to you guys, but if everyone's experiencing it, it's my fault somehow. I apologize. Just bear with it, and or just watch it later on YouTube. I appreciate the support. There's nothing I can do about that until I figure out what the hell's going on with my connection between here and Twitch. I just know that never happened when I was streaming on YouTube. Alright. 220. 230. 240. 250. Alright, let's see if... Oops. Oh my goodness. Does anyone have any suggestions? Except I haven't hit the apron yet, so that still might be my fault. I keep getting loose before I hit the apron. Second. Alright. Seems like the frames are alright for now. The connection, that is. No dropped frames. Good. I always have trouble controlling the car the more I turn the grip up. Now let's try around 240. I still need to have enough control of the car and be towards the bottom of the track to be able to hit the apron. Come on. Oh, damn it. Alright, I think it's... I'm yet to get a clean shot at the apron where I'm going, where I haven't lost much speed, so... It still might be my fault. Oh. That never happened. No one saw that. That attempt was bad from the get-go. Not even gonna watch that replay. Get off the wall. There we go. So I need to keep it off the wall and not lose traction before I downshift. This time I need to be able to hit the apron, going at a fast enough speed to hopefully upside down. God damn it. Maybe I need to... Maybe since I'm actually getting loose just from the sheer speed, maybe I should just try that without... and not actually just downshift. Maybe I'll just try getting loose at the right spot and hopefully hit the apron at the right angle to get some air underneath the car. We shall hope. I need to start up high and then dive down low. I'm gonna try to slide at the right angle. Shoot, get off the wall. Alright, I'm trying next lap, I guess. Where am I? Where am I? Nope. It's the bad Daytona infield wall wreck Cale Yarborough never had. Kind of similar to Ricky Rudd, Darrell Waltrip, and Randy LaJoy's. Kind of a combination of all of them. No, I'm not trying Dario Franchitti's crash. No serious injuries, remember? No fatals and or seriously injured. I could try his flip at Michigan or Kentucky, however. Speaking of Dario Franchitti. Off the wall. Alright, can anyone give me any suggestions as to what I'm doing wrong? I'll try going on board this time. Maybe that'll help. Damn, I should save that first replay where... where he actually got upside down. So I'm yet to get upside down since. Alright, I think that's the wrong move, trying to downshift into... into reverse. I think that's the wrong move. Alright. I'm gonna try my original plan of... or my plan B of sliding naturally and hopefully hitting the apron at the right angle. I might just have to turn the grip up just one or two more decimals. There we go. Aw, damn it. Alright, I think I'm getting a better idea for what I need to do. I need to just kind of start up high, ease off the gas a little bit, go down into the corner, and then as I'm starting to drift on the corner into turn four, then I need to stomp on the gas to kind of bring the end of the car around and hopefully be coming down at a right enough angle to where I can still hit the apron before the momentum of taking me up the track takes over and I start sliding back up the track. Need to hit the apron before that happens. Alright, so ease off the gas a little bit. Aw, damn it. Anyone have any suggestions?
Let's see.
Yeah, I'm gonna try turning the grip up just a tad. Because when I'm sliding down, maybe having the grip up, turning it up just a little bit will be able to help me go down to the corner as opposed to sliding back up the track from the momentum. I'll be able to get down into the corner just enough to hit the apron. And the grip usually helps turn the speed up a little bit too. Alright, so I will do that. Window cap. Daytona. Track INI. Alright, so let's do another 2/10. So 2.05 and then 2.1. Let's see what that does. I'll try turning the wind up too. After this, if I'm still not having any luck, I'll turn the wind down to zero. Because I'm not sure if I'm hurting or helping my chances by adjusting the wind. I have no idea, I'm just guessing. Alright, here we go. I think I accidentally went into the YouTube chat mode there for a second. Alright. See if that made a difference. fourth time hitting single race. I'll try adjusting the transmission too after this. And I'm already going faster. Going to Lake Lloyd. Oh no, the banking kicked me back. Well, as Ron Burgundy would say, that escalated quickly. I thought with the heightened grip I wouldn't be prone to having that happen. Well, at least I can get airborne on the backstretch. At least that can happen. Try not to have that happen again. Let's wait to get to turn four to have that blow over happen again. Right, stay tucked down to the bottom. There we go. I'm gonna ease off the gas a little bit. So I still can get sideways, even with the grip up as high as it is. So I need to be coming down at a right angle and then kick the back end of the car out like I was doing last time. Let's try this, too. Where's what I'm looking for? No. I meant garage. See if that makes any difference. Adjusting the transmission ratio a bit to make my car have a slightly faster top speed, if my knowledge of that setting is correct. Yesterday. There, he flipped. Does that count? Why is it only the infield grass that the grip is affected on? The trioval. It's only this grass that has a higher grip than all the other.
We got big time problems with that motor, buddy.
Hey, it's still drivable. Is it still drivable?
You're smoking out there.
Let's see how many times I can roll the car over before the engine stops working. Probably gonna do it right there. Yep. That's the one that killed her. Yeah, there's probably a different setting. I might actually try a different Daytona. Let's see if I have what other Daytonas I have. I just wanna see this replay. Yeah. That was right under the driver's side roof. Wall first. He would have had a headache. All right, let's see what other Daytonas I have. 1 second. I'm finding my backup folder. Mods. No, not mods. Tracks. All right, where is the window? Here we go. Super Speedways. All right, so we have 88, which I believe I have in the game. GN70. All right, let's try these two. Excuse me. Although one of these doesn't work. I think it's this one that doesn't work, so... Wait. So I'll try copying this one into the game. I think that's the only other Daytona I really have from that era, at least downloaded. Alright, so let's go into the actual game folder. Paste. Let's look at the settings for 88, see if I can... I'm going to switch the settings similar to what I have now for the 88 track. 30, 40. Save. And same thing with the... this one. I'm going to switch over the settings. Similar to what I have for the other tracks. Just the base settings to help me get airborne in the turn, which I can't think of any other thing I could do. All right, save. We need to close this out. Then reload it so the settings take effect. Reload the game. Bring the comments back. Single race, let's see. It's basically like the same one. Well, let's see if it makes any difference. So good. About the same speed, same feel as the other one, so it looks like the settings translated over fine. Alright, so I actually felt like I wanted to get loose naturally there, but by the time I hit the apron, I was still too far forward that I didn't quite get all the way around, so I'll try that again. See if I can be a little bit more sideways by the time I hit the apron to get some air underneath the car. Oh, that's dangerous. This one might, it seems a little better in terms of getting that slide I need in the corner. I just overcorrected before I was all the way around this time. So I'll try it again a few times with this track. If I can't get any better luck with this one, I'll try the 88 version. Jesus, talk about a hard hit to the driver's side door. attempt. Is it lagging? Yep, we're dropping some frames, guys. Sorry. Sorry, just bear with it or watch it later on YouTube. You don't have to stay with it. It's been good for the most part so far. I was honestly surprised we were doing this good. I don't know if you guys can hear me and when it's lagging or not, but if you can, you don't have to stay with it. You can just check back in a few minutes. I do not blame you if you exit out. Or you can check it out on YouTube afterwards. Hello, all you YouTube watchers. No, it's dropping frames. It's not buffering for you guys. Oh. Oh, damn it. All right, so I'm close. I'm close. Aw, damn, I was really hoping the grass would have kind of... Aside from not going all the way upside down, the rest of the wreck was basically perfect. So I'm going to save that at least for a thumbnail. Let's take a look at this one. Yeah, even the way he hit the wall and then slid back down, it's pretty close. Alright, so Cale... I'll say Yarborough 83 flip attempt 1. Okay. Alright, let's try that again. Alright, so I have a feeling of what I need to do. I'm kind of getting that slide and then hitting the apron down. I think I'm got the right settings for the most part. Maybe I need to adjust the wind a little bit into a certain direction. Is there any way I can figure out that out? Which direction I would need the wind to be blowing in order to be hitting the car in that certain direction to get underneath when he's facing that way? Like, for example, if you were looking at Daytona from aerial view, which direction, northeast, southwest, would the wind basically going reverse of, like, turn 4 be? Then I could figure out what direction that is, adjust that direction, then crank the wind up. Maybe that would help? I have no idea. Oh. That was a little too sudden that time. Need the car to... the back end to come around a bit more slowly. One second. I'll be right back. I gotta go get a drink. Throat was getting really dry. Alright. Sorry about that. So I think I have the... I know how I need the... kind of the direction and angle I need to go down and slide into the banking. It's just a matter of execution. Executing it properly. ease off the gas just a little bit so I don't slide all the way up, which I still did anyway. That would be a really impressive save if you guys didn't know about the grip levels. Southwest or southeast is the wind direction. Alright, or just south in general might help. I need to redo the session anyway. That's right, I didn't turn the grip up for the infield grass. Got out of hand quickly. 1996 Dale Earnhardt flip. Put that on the to-do list. That one would be tricky though. Very tricky indeed. Because a few other cars get together behind him. Nope, I'm going into the Lake Lloyd. Understatement. Well, at least you know the wind temperature is down, because even though the grip is still almost at 2, the back end still came around. Calm down, Braden. You're not the only one that's had that idea. More drop frames. Sorry, guys. Hopefully it'll be over in a few moments like it was last time. It's like a T-Rex. If you just ignore it, it'll go away. I think that's the rule of thumb for internet lag. It's like a T-Rex. Isn't that what they say? Oops. Alright. Guess it's gonna be the next lap. More. We're still lagging, aren't we? Yep. We still got fucking drop frame issues. I have no idea what the fuck causes that. I'm almost fairly certain, though, it's from other people streaming Netflix and other stuff in my house, taking bandwidth away from the router, or however that technology works. Oh, damn it. Alright, so far that one was the closest I've had. Hey, he flipped. Reenactment over. Alright, next. Man, that one, I had the perfect angle. I just didn't quite get airborne enough. To get upside down. Everything else is perfect. At least I saved the replay. off the gas a little bit. Slowly start sliding, then crank it.
Oh,
damn it. I almost had it there. I'll try one more lap around before I restart the session. Of course, that time the slide works. Alright, damaged engine. Next attempt. Ken Schrader flip at Daytona. I scrolled past that. Whenever I am thinking of what reenactment I want to try, I always look at your guys' suggestions for new ones, and then I also go to NASCAR All Out page, the NASCAR Flips playlist, and see what... Just take a glance and see if I have any ones that I catch my eye in my game. Oh, damn it. Alright, so that slide was almost good. I just needed to get sideways just a hair sooner than I did. Because otherwise the spin down to the apron was good. I just wasn't quite sideways enough at that point. Right there, when I got down the apron to actually get air underneath the car. And then by the time I actually was backwards, I was slowed down. So, I think with each passing attempt, I'm starting to get in the hang of what I need to do. I don't think I need to try 88, because I think this version's working good. I just need to be able to execute the spin properly. I was a little too late into the turn, and I was stuck on the wall anyway, but at least that was promising. Of getting airborne at least, but that was way too late into the turn, and yeah, I was stuck on the wall first. I mainly spun because I was trying to get off the wall. Damn, 93 followers? I haven't even looked at my followers in a while. Last I saw, I was like 60-something. Almost at 100, thanks you guys. Damn. Only a few months. That was gonna be a year or so before I got 100. Ah, darn it. Once again, I didn't execute that one properly. I'll try again next lap before I restart the qualifying session. Even though the grip's up at 2 with the track temperature lowered, it still gives it a realistic feel of if you crank the wheel too hard to either side, the back end is going to kick out. Oh, damn it. Wheelie. Someone gave me an interesting idea for a wreck. Ron Uhlenfeld, 1965. I forgot who. I'll point out his name on the next stream I do. But someone suggested, since a bunch of photos and information recently came out of a wreck I never knew happened, Dale Earnhardt qualifying, I believe, for the 89 500. The 1989 500 actually got out of control in the tri-oval. Tumbled a few times and got into the catch fence. So I was thinking, he suggested I try to do that, to almost try to reenact it. Oh, damn it. All right, that spin was decent. I just needed to be going faster. So yeah, he suggested that I try to reenact that, since there's no actual known footage of that. And that would be a really cool idea. That also got me thinking I could try doing that with this game for other crashes that there's no good footage of. Like Brad Keselowski's Road Atlanta bad wreck he had a few years ago, his Watkins Glen wreck he had like a year or two ago. So yeah, I was thinking that'd be a cool series to do. Like wrecks you might not have seen or wrecks you haven't seen. Still don't know. If I do that, I don't know what I would name that series other than wrecks you haven't seen or crashes you haven't seen. NASCAR All Out? I know he posted the video of that. I'm not sure. Was that him that actually suggested it on one of my videos? If so, that's cool knowing we watch each other's videos. Alright. Oh, damn it. Just a little too... All good. Next. I'm getting closer and closer with the spin. I tried Richard Petty's flip, I didn't get it yet though, so that's gonna need a part two. And a lot of videos in the comments, I see a lot of people suggesting ones I've already tried, but then I see someone say he already did it. Sometimes it's when I've tried it, but I haven't actually got it. So you can say I already did it, but he never got a good attempt, so we'd like to see a part two. Because, yeah. Oh, damn it. Alright, so the spin's getting better. I just need to actually get lucky and get upside down. So yeah, when people suggest ideas and then you say, or people say he already did it, it's a little misleading, think I actually got the reenactment. But yeah, if I've tried it in the past, if you notice someone commenting that, if you happen to comment back, just make sure you say, yeah, he's tried it, but he hasn't gotten it yet, so we're waiting for a part two or three or etc. Oh yeah, that's another idea I had. People have asked me to how I make my reenactments. I've been thinking about doing a video of that recently. But I'd want like a really easy wreck to do so I could have the entire video be live from the start of the wreck to me finishing editing. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, damn it. Come on, Cale. Lettuce Yarborough. That was a terrible joke. Let's see if this one works. Still that one where I got on my side was the closest I've had. Didn't quite get upside down. Aw, damn it. I didn't quite hit the apron that time. A little backwards wheelie off the Daytona mound. Does anyone know why that giant mound is there? Is that leftover earth from when they dug out Lake Lloyd? would be my guess. Although you'd think they could just haul that away in some bullet or some dump trucks. I get a decent one and he just starts tumbling over and over again. Alright, so I'm getting the settings right. I have the settings right, and I'm starting to get the execution right. It's just a matter of luck of getting the right rec. Because, yeah, that one was mostly good airborne-wise, but then he started tumbling. I'm kind of glad that one didn't work, because I had all the smoke and tire marks from the last attempt that I forgot to get rid of by hitting this button. Alright, so yes, definitely getting closer. As if I do need to do a part two to this one, at least I know what track and settings I need to use, so I can basically just jump right in. And I know what I need to do, the execution I need to do, in terms of how I need to go into that turn and spin at just the right angle. Have the grip while I'm getting loose to go down to the bottom of the track, but not get so loose to the point where I'm sliding back up the track before I get to the apron. It's all about hitting that sweet spot. Damn it. See, that time the back end got around a little too quickly to where I was already starting to go back up the track before I got a clean shot at hitting the apron. Daytona, yes, I've tried that. Or no, I haven't tried that. I need to try that. But that one would be hard, because, yeah, that's one where someone got into another person, and then that other person was way sideways, and then he got into Rusty, which sent him over. So I have no idea how I'd do that, and it'd be hard to do that one online, because he was basically in the middle of a pack with like 40 cars, so I don't think I could try that online. Aw, damn it. Getting closer. No, don't exit. Glad I developed the method I'm trying now, as opposed to just hitting reverse and trying to spin the car that way, because this looks much more natural. Oh, damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it. Let's actually try going on board. 4-1, maybe that'll help me slide at the right angle I need to. Plus you get to hear what a NASCAR Cup engine sounds like at 240 miles an hour. Got airborne and set back down. That's what happened. Alright guys, it's probably going to be the fifth to last attempt. Five to go. So I gotta get going soon. Got some stuff to do, and then I work tonight, unfortunately. This is only going to be the one stream today. I've been trying to for the last week do two a day. I just didn't do a racing one earlier because I was editing the Randy LaJoy flip, so I hope that makes up for it. And hopefully it should be done processing by now, so go check it out. is attempt number 1 out of 5. And of course, right when I say I'm doing the last attempts, the stream starts cutting out. Sorry guys, watch the last attempts on YouTube. Nothing else I can say. Other than fuck Twitch. No, I don't mean that. I like Twitch, but gives me a few more issues than I ever had with YouTube. In terms of live streaming, which is funny because it's all Twitch does. You guys freaking out in all caps about the frames isn't gonna make them go away any better. So calm your tits, everyone. Alright, 3 to go. You can check out the rest of the stream on YouTube. For fuck's sakes, no reason to freak out in all caps. Is it going away yet? Nope, of course I look up and it's still messing up. Oh. Saved it. I'm just angrily staring up at my laptop, staring at the stream cutting out every 2 seconds. Come on, damn it. Come on. Sorry guys, no backwards this time. I'm already running late. And there's no point of doing a backwards thing if you guys aren't even going to be able to see it. Do the stupid drop frames. Alright, second to last attempt. I know all you on YouTube watching this right now are just wondering what the hell I'm ranting about, but people watching on Twitch right now are having trouble viewing it live. Oh, damn it. I was almost at the right angle for that one. I just needed to be sideways just a hair earlier. I think it's less than 3 months now, guys. It's more than halfway done from the original sentencing. My punishment of having my live streaming on YouTube revoked. By the way, I'll answer it quickly in case someone asks me on this video for the millionth time. Can't stream on Twitch temporarily for a few months more, because back during the last race of the season, I tried streaming my reaction, and it didn't go well, and it got banned for copyright, and I got my rights revoked for live streaming for 6 months. Even though I was just streaming my reaction to the damn race. With ad revenue turned off. Attempt is the charm. For fuck's sakes. Alright, that is it for the stream today, guys. Wish I had better luck. At least I got that one decent attempt, at least for the YouTube thumbnail. Thanks so much for watching. Hit the like button. Follow me on Twitch if you aren't already. Subscribe on YouTube. Thanks to all of you that are. Until tomorrow, I will see you next time. Have a good rest of your day, guys. Peace.